Hey everyone, my name is Felipe Schmidt. In today's video, we are going to show how we can use the My To-Dos configuration under My Tasks in the Employee Center. So how we can configure it and how we can make another look and feel in there so that you can add useful information what you need. So let's deep dive on it. So first of all, what we are talking about. Whenever you are in the Employee Center, what you can do is always go to My Tasks. And in here is where you find this information. You have the My Tasks, in which it contains open and completed. Here is how you filter the types of records that you want to show in here. In this specific scenario, we are going to use everything out of the box. I'm not going to configure new stuff. But what we're going to focus right now is how we can show specific information in here. Because this, as you see in here, is out of the box. So first of all, let's start with the to-dos configuration. First of all, I'm going to unimpersonate because I was impersonating another user. And how you can find it is basically typing Employee Center. When you type Employee Center, the most important part that you need to focus right now is the to-dos configuration. Whenever you click in here, you have this specific table that is going to open. And as you see, you already have a hint in here regarding the tab. So if you group by tab, you're going to see that you have open and completed tab, exactly as it's matching in here. So it means that you need to configure a specific view for the completed and for the open if you want to. And here, what we're going to do, we're going to filter for active ones only. And we are going to configure something for approvals and approvals for change requests, something that we don't have yet. Because this is how it looks like whenever you have an approval for a record that you don't have a specific configuration to show something in here. This is the raw one. And now we want to add and make a little bit better, let's say like this. But if you need simply something directly from out of the box, this is a really a good one to go, you know. So let's go for the open ones. Well, as soon as you click on approvals, then you have this big condition in here. And this condition is just saying to you which kind of records are going to appear in that list so that you can filter the records. And this you can ignore for now, because for now we are going to focus on this specific task configurations or the to-dos widget mappings in here. What is the most important thing to understand and the difference between both is task configurations is something that you simply configure and you don't need to type any kind of code in here. So you're going to see, we're going to use this one because we're going to use no code for that. This specific to-dos widget mappings in here, it would replace exactly the to-dos configuration in case you need some complex logic in order to pull some specific information for that widget to show in there. So this is what needs to be clear. So you don't need both, you just need one. And if you need something that you can do without coding, you're using this. If you need something that you need coding, you're using the widget mappings itself. Now let's focus on the task configurations. In here, you see that we have two configured ones. We have for requests and we have for requested items. Those ones, I don't think we have an example in here, but basically all the open ones here are for changes. But now we're going to create one for change, and you're going to see that directly this is going to modify. And here, let's say we want for change request. This isn't going to be the name of the tab that we can simply easily find out afterwards. And these are only a condition. Here is approval for, and we are going to say that we want for change request. So all the change requests details are going to be visible in that part. Now it's the most important thing for the configuration itself. And that's exactly what I mentioned before, that sometimes you need some complex logic in order to show some information or not. And in this kind of situation, you can configure everything you need. And here you have the common info fields type, which you can say fields or you can type custom. And in custom, you can simply add with comma separated list of fields that you want to show. But in we are going to use everything the standard one. So fields, comma, info fields, we are going to say, for example, let's say state and approver. And link to task means that as soon as you click in the record, it's going to redirect the user to the standard ticket page. So I'm going to leave it like this for now. Primary info here basically has to do with our page in here, that everything that is going to be shown here inside. So I'm going to simply put something like approval for, and we're going to put the number. So here, and some other fields, we're going to put created and created by, for example, only as a matter of example. We are not interested right now into finalize the whole configuration. First of all, it's really good to understand why and where these kind of mappings here they are. So now we have saved, we have created. I'm going to impersonate the user so that we can see this card right now working. And as you see right now, we have modified that. It's not as it was before. What are the key points in here? We have now the state and it has a link. Remember that I just told that we can link something to somewhere. This is exactly the link. So whenever you click in here, you're going to be redirected to the standard ticket page so that the user can see the some information of the tab and everything that is in here. So this is where it is. This you can simply unclick there, so you can set to false and the link will be removed, so the user cannot go to that page. Here is the common info tab. So the field state and approver, field state and approver. And here is the link. Now, this part below is exactly the primary info. So everything that is going to be displayed for the user, in which you have the approval number and the created and created by. So approval number, created and created by. These are the fields and how you can configure that. But now you might ask, Felipe, where is the approval button and where is the reject button? And that's what we need. And we are going to the third tab, which is the important one, the action tab. And in here, I'm just going to need to unimpersonate so that I can perform the action as an admin. And I'm coming here and I have the approval actions group. And this approval actions group, we have spoken in another video, that contains a group of actions from the action framework. So if you go to Employee Center, you have this action framework, action groups, and this is exactly the approvals action group. So whenever you save this, so now we have an action group set for this specific task configuration. So we have configured our common field. I'm going to also set this to false so that you can see how it looks like. And I'm going to now impersonate again to that user that we were checking. And as soon as you do that, two things to notice. The link is gone that we have set to false. And now we have the two buttons approve and reject that exactly behaves as it we have in the my active items widget in here, approve and reject. And that's how you can simply configure this page in here. So as a wrap up of this video, the key takeaways are, whenever you need to create some details page for your approvals, you just need to make sure to create, if you don't need any kind of code, the task configuration for that with the common information, primary information, and the actions button that are going to appear. If there are some actions that are going to really apply for that. If not, you don't really need to use that. Second part is, whenever you need some kind of really complex logic, then you can use and create a new widget so that you can link and create an HTML part for that. And you can use some glide records in order to grab the information and show to the user exactly in this part of here. So that's it. If you have any comments or any suggestions, please let me know in the comments down below. Don't forget to like the video and subscribe to the channel. See you next time.